SMF, MMTs, it is a Sunday and it's 12:48 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and we're going into that wonderful Merry Christmas week. The triple witch is beyond us now, MMTs. Price actional directional movement based, are the S&P 500 companies breaking higher or are they breaking lower as a group? We're going to find out as we move in to the $1,250 call right here. And I've got the $1,250 put. Let us not forget that the S&P itself closed at 1243.91. And we're going to take a look at the premium. We're going to take a look at this put contract was $60 right here. MM. The high was 82.50. The date was on 11/30. And that means that we have a low put in at 2380 MMTs. And if the S&P does not break and close above the 1250 strike price, then this put option is deflated. Remember, it's had a chance to come off of $82.50. We're going to get down into the pricing wholesale triggers and getting this S&P 500 index ready to trade. On the other hand, we're going to take a look here. As you can see that the high here on this contract, the high here was $25. When the wholesale bid is down here in that deflated area at $6, the breakout of that contract, the low was 6.25 right here on 11:30, and we popped up and made this near-term high of 23.53, which is a lower high than the $25 ones. And now we're coming back down into the zone. Now this is a 12:50 call. If the S&P pulls back, then this is going to lose value, and after the tape is over, and that means that its counterpartner, the 1250 put, is going to go up in value. So depending on which way the S&P wants to trade, if we're going to be in a breakout mode short term, then of course buying down here at the stable price for a quick trade is a trade to do. However, one has to be ready to pound this 1250 put that is slightly in the money. Because it is. Let's make sure that the full video for you here is in there for pricing control. Here are your pricing controls right here. So we're going to be watching the level between the two contracts here. This is the wholesale bid here. This is the 1250 call is this chart, and this one's 1250 put. So we can see both of these in the video right here right now. And what we're going to measure here, let me move this over. What we're going to measure here is how the price imbalances in our platform tells us what side of that S&P 500 to get on. Because that 1250 in the put, a failure to break above seven handles and get above that resistance area in the S&P is that we're going to be trading the 1250 put. That's so far there. We're going to take a look at up and out of the money calls. Here's a put that we're going to put in here. That there, you can see what the 1170 put bar was, but the 1270 put bar was. Let's take a look on the other hand. Let's get that 1270 call up and out of the money. Now, this is a 1270 call that was down at $3.37. Its interim high back on 11.5 was 15.90. Currently, the price on the low of Friday was 8.5 for that 1270 call up and out of the money. Now, MMTs would be using this kind of a contract at a wholesale price as a hedge for roller coaster gaps in the futures market in the morning, so that if we gap up, we would sell into that and watch the put side. But we're going to watch this put side for this in the money put, because the high over here was 56.20. A spot check low shows that at 38. We're just going to monitor how they treat the contract and how they can take the premium and drop a low here at $34 from $45. That's a $10 drop in this 1270 put in the money. So we're going to see just how far they take this down in value and how much credibility we get over here and this 1270 call up and out of the money, which we would look at some point in time on how to develop up and out of the money hedge for volatility price action hedging when trading the S&P 500 options index. They're very tricky and whatnot. Another thing we're going to look at is below the market right here. This chart is a put option. And basically, if you take a look at it, the 1240 put below, slightly below the market, the low is 1940. The spot highs way back over here are highs at 24s. So this one here, you can see the pricing mechanism already in play, and that's the 1240 put. One of the things we're going to be monitoring, on the other hand, is the 1240 call that was wholesale over here at 890 and hit a retail price, once again, a high of 2764. The closing price is a low of 22 MMTs. So basically, that 1240 call, if we pull back, this call is going to lose value. And it's got a lot of room below it here. Well, guess what? If the call loses the money, then that means that the in-the-money 1240 put breaks higher, so the inflated goes down and the deflated goes up. This is a 1240 put that's actually in the money on the S&P, so therefore, deflate down and reflate up in price action. Depending on what the actual indexes are going to do, we're going to be monitoring that one. I'm going to give the pricing structures off of the video, and I'm going to make sure that MMTs love trading these. So basically, we're going to go through those pricing controls and how to gauge slightly below the handle on the S&P. The close is 1243.31, 40 and 1240. 1240 call. 1240 put. Inflated to the top, it's in its pullback, and that's deflated. So if we correct, we're buying, and bam, up you go. You do have room to go. The last highs over here were $28. So the low here was 1940. So there is a move back up here, and there's a, so if this moves down, we're moving that way. I will go over other ones during the new trading week and as we move through the Christmas holiday and the New Year's. There's lots of time on these. Once again, we've got the complete S&P 500 spreads that we're going to need, and deflated, inflated using the SMF Market Maker platform and the Market Maker option pit.